Welcome to the William H. Pitt Center in Fairfield, Connecticut. It's the semifinals of the Northeast Conference Tournament. The ladies of Sacred Heart taking on the St. Francis Red Flash.
1-1, 2-2-1.
That Sparks on the drive, gets her own rebound. Open three. Can't leave Allie Williams open. She has five.
Offensively and aggressive defensively.
Konashevsky blocked away by Dugan. Dugan on the move. And Konashevsky does a nice job getting back. But Sparks fires the three. Rebecca Sparks. She has two of those threes early. Sparks the steal. She's been a burst of energy. Crosses over for the finish.
And she's got it on both ends. She's a not great scorer. Morgan Merriman can get you some points.
Norman can penetrate. Finds Merriman. And the foul.
Well, that's what they're going to.
Full court press. That's the 2-2-1 it looks like. And Erica Norman, look at that speed. Breaks it all by herself in the finish.
Well, we mentioned at the beginning, it's got to make that up fake. Angele has got to fake and then take it. And again, the answer right back. The Red Flash, they are not going away.
Leads down to 18.
And she's had good looks in this ball game so far. Hasn't been able to convert.
Gibbs, stop and pop.
Great answer for St. Francis. Gibbs just coming down. That median range jumper wide open.
Sacred Heart running. Pull up for Washington. Friendly roll. And here comes Sacred Heart. Gabrielle Washington. Launches the three.
Got it. Eddie Swanson with a quick timeout.
Allie Williams gets it across. Back to her. And it counts. Williams with the great give and go. The Red Flash beat the Pioneers 83-67.
I'm here now, right now, with the winning coach, O'Hay, from the Red Flash of St. Francis. At the outset of this ball game, you guys put a whipping on him. You came with such intensity, both defensively and offensively, and I have to ask you this. Was your game plan to just make layups all game long? Because you had a ton of them, Joe.
Well, we hit a couple threes, too. You know, we had that one, like you said, right before the halftime. No, the game plan, and our kids did a great job of it. Our game plan was to try and make it really tough on Norman to catch the ball, and that was our full court pressure. We adjusted it for this game, and our kids played their hearts out, really. You know, and then we got, and they were pressing us, so we were attacking the rim. We don't ever want to play tentative, and we only had a couple little lapses where our intensity dropped, and they came back at us.
Well, but I thought Sparks and Gibbs, right, they were outstanding against Norman. And Norman's a heck of a good player in her own right, but I think she tired, too. And I think your defense really did a job on there. You knew they had to make a run. What were you thinking when they cut it down? The closest they got was 11. They couldn't get to that magical 10.
Well, I think they got it. Like, I think it was 10 at 53, 43 when he got it. It was close at
5:08.
You know, we just wanted to calm our kids down because we started getting a little bit shaky, and they made that run at it. But we told them before the game, it's a game of runs, and luckily we had a few more of them. That's what we told them in the timeout. Like, okay. It's a game of runs. Be patient. we'll get a good look. And then, I mean, Sparks just played an unbelievable game. Allie Williams played great.
Well, we're going to bring Allie in a minute, but just so you know, you're playing Quinnipiac. They sneaked one out. I think it was 63-56.
Wow.
So you're at Quinnipiac.
Well, Quinnipiac's a great team.
Absolutely. So. Joe, best
we'll
of luck
see.
With the championship game.
All right, I appreciate
okay,
it.
Okay, no
you.
Problem. We'll bring in Allie Williams right now. Allie? Allie, congratulations
Thank
on an
you.
Outstanding game. Just talked to Coach about the intensity. Did you guys work on this intensity in practice coming up here?
Yeah, I mean, we had a tough week, even though people are saying less is more at this point. We went at it for 20 minutes. We had halves. We play against Coach Eddie. He's on the scout team, and oh, he is good. He's like the leading scorer from Vermont, so he pushes us, and we worked really hard today or this week in practice, and Tiff was the scout for this, and we knew the scout like the back of our hand, and we were really prepared, and I'm really proud of our team.
Well, I think you should be. The two games that you lost were 20 points, 21 and 25. You come in here and you spanked them early on.
Mm-hmm.
They made that run in the second half. What was going on in your mind during that run?
We said don't panic, because we always come out slow and that's it for us. But when they get a run, we just got to keep our composure. We remembered that we were up 10. It was our game. It was our game the whole time from the start. And we really just didn't let it get to us. We kept pushing on and it pulled through for us.
Maybe the happiest bus ride you've ever taken on the way back to Loretto tonight.
Yeah. Well, we're staying until Sunday.
Until Sunday?
Yeah,
okay.
Not fun.
Not fun at all. You're going to play Quinnipiac, in case you didn't know that yet.
I mean, we're ready. We didn't do well against the first time, but the second time we did well, I think, but they came and got us in the end. So, I mean, Quinnipiac's a great team, but we can give them a good fight.
Allie had an outstanding game today. Best of luck against Quinnipiac.
Thank you very much.
Congratulations.
Thank you.